You hear plenty of stories about athletes overcoming obstacles to get to the Olympic Games, but some journeys take a few more turns than others. Back in 2006, American skeleton athlete Noelle Pikus Pace missed the Torino Games with an injury, and then 4 years later, she came up short of the podium in Vancouver. And since that time, her life has only gotten more crowded.
In the sleepy suburbs of Salt Lake City, Noelle Pikus Pace has an unlikely training program for a world-class athlete. But there is some running.
This run. Cold.
Lifting weights.
You're getting heavy. Who needs weight training when you have kids?
And an adherence to a strict diet.
Are you full? Do you have just a couple of bites?
I wake up, I get dressed, I get the kids ready, get them dressed. I'll take Lacey to preschool, and then I have a two-hour window where I have to get my workout in, and that's really not that much time at all.
I'll be back, bud.
And when I lift, when I run, my kids are right by my side. I take them to the track, and they're running around. I have to sometimes stop in the middle of the workout to take care of a crying baby or somebody's poopy, but it's great. I love it.
When Pikus Pace first became a mother 6 years ago, skeleton often came before family. But after she finished fourth at the Vancouver Olympics...
Oh, man. So close, a tenth of a second, you know?
She decided the pursuit of gold wasn't worth the sacrifice.
I actually retired the day after the Olympics in 2010. I was done with traveling and being away from them for 5 to 6 months at a time, and we wanted to have more kids.
Where's your coat?
Trayson was born March 23rd, 2011. That was one of the most incredible experiences of my life.
That's the peppers. You do the peppers.
Mama.
Nice work, sweetie. In April of 2012, I got pregnant with a third. We found out that we were going to have a little girl. We were thinking of names and everything. I actually had a miscarriage. That was at 18 weeks. Being told that your baby's heart just stopped and you don't know why, nobody knew why. They couldn't tell me. They didn't have an answer. It was really hard. Coming back to skeleton was definitely in response to having a miscarriage. It gave me something to move towards. We've been traveling as a family, and that's really the only way that I would come back to compete is if we could do this as a family.
Holy dynamite, that is fast.
She's back, baby.
She is flying.
It's the best feeling to have them up at the top of the track as that green light goes off. Sometimes I just hear, Mama, 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 and they're crying. And I'm like, okay, focus. I'll see them in 60 seconds.
Noelle Pikus Pace and her family have enjoyed the success. They've endured the injury. They swallowed the retirement and rallied in the comeback. But the wait for an Olympic medal has been far too long. Now is her time. Farewell games, farewell drives, farewell runs are always special. This is it for Noelle Pikus Pace.
Did you see that moment? That moment of prayer there. She closed her eyes and had her last focused anticipation of what she wants out of this run.
In 2005, she won the World Cup. She was then hit in a training accident by a four-man bobsled. 9 weeks later, she came back, but she missed the Torino Games. She had to wait another 4 years for Vancouver and missed the podium by a tenth of a second. She's had to wait to now. This is her final Olympic run for that elusive medal.
All of these turns, what she's carrying with her is her family. The only reason that she is here today is because her and Jansen, who built her sled, that's her husband, decided that they wanted to give this one more go as a family together.
Noelle Pikus Pace has that Olympic medal.
Her medal.
She finally has it.
Oh my gosh!
Nice job.
We did it! We did it!
Nice job.